sweet your eyes are like two jewels in the sky. Your back is straight, your hair is smooth on the pillow where you lie. But I don't sense affection, no gratitude or love. Your loyalty is not to me, but to the stars above. One more cup of coffee for the road. One more cup of coffee for I go to the valley below. Your daddy, you how to pick and choose and how to throw the blade. He oversees his kingdom, so no stranger does intrude. His voice it trembles as he calls for another plate of food. One more cup of coffee for the road. Like your mama and yourself. You've never learned to read or write. There's no books upon your shelf. And your pleasure knows no limits. Your voice is like a meadow lark. But your heart is like an ocean, so mysterious and dark. One more cup of coffee for the road. One more cup of coffee for I go to the valley below.
Welcome to this first step of playing One More Cup of Coffee. We are going to look at the individual parts here, a bunch of examples, and then they are what is used when I play the full arrangement. And then when you can play them, there's little tab loops for you to practice along each one with. When you can play them, we can play this song in its entirety. We do it with a singer, you play along with me, and then following that, we're also going to create a second guitar part, which means that we can play this song together. That's nice, isn't it? So let's start off here with example one. That makes sense, doesn't it? So the point with this song here is that it's a four chord song, really. We're starting with the verse here. It's A minor, G, F, and E. So it's the song is in A minor. That's our home, chord 6. And then we go down to chord 5, and then to chord 4. We want to play that with a C in the bass, which is the fifth of an F. If that's the full F, we don't want to play. We play it just with a C there, to fatten it up a bit. And then an E. E is chord 3. So that's 6, 5, 4, 3. But 3 should have been minor. We don't want that. We want major. Because that's what's in these songs. So we call that a 3x. The rhythm is this. And it doesn't change. It's just this all the time. So the variation is going to come from how hard and soft we play it. Different chord shapes, using different inversions, you call it that, but I like to call it chord shapes, because that makes more sense, of these chords. Same strumming pattern, same chords, just different shapes, some extensions as well, but mainly different shapes. And then different amounts of each chord. So sometimes we might play that for the A minor in the beginning of a bar, sometimes we might play that, sometimes we might just play the bass note first. So here we go, here's example one, full A minor. Okay, so very detailed tab here. You gotta look into this really deeply and get it exactly as it's written, because that's the whole point of this lesson, basically. And then when we come to the G here, we play open strings from in the, we're still in A minor bar, we play open strings to get us to the G, and then we hold them, and then we play the bass note. Two, three, four. Two, three, four. That G there is full up there. Oh, three, the third is present in this chord, it's a G, it's not a G5. And then that F over C. Open strings there. E. And here the strumming pattern actually changes, it's this. And then back again. See, the weight here is on B2. There. There. Let's hear it to a click. So that was example one. Example two, very similar, just a bit smaller. So this is, if the first one is when it's no singing, this one would be when it's singing, to not get in the way too much. So smaller here. It's those three.